International Mandela Day delivered under different circumstances. The global pandemic, COVID-19, having turned the world upside down, shining the spotlight on humanity's weaknesses. The world's chief diplomat weighing in heavily.
It is exposing fallacies, the falsehoods everywhere. The lie that free markets can deliver healthcare for all. The fiction that unpaid care work is not work. The delusion that we live in a post-racist world. The myth that we are all in the same boat. Because while we are all floating on the same sea, it is clear that some are in super yachts, with others are clinging to drifting debris.
And that was the thrust of his speech, saying inequality can no longer be tolerated. Not only have the poor been shortchanged, they continue to bear the brunt. He didn't mince his words about the continued suffering of Africa at the hands of the rich.
Africa has been a double victim. First, as a target of the colonial project. Second, African countries are underrepresented in the international institutions that were created after the Second World War because before, most of them had won independence. The nations that came out on top more than seven decades ago have refused to contemplate the reforms needed to change power relations in international institutions.
The UN chief said all was not lost. This could be an opportunity to right the wrongs. From restructuring global institutions to embracing new technology to serve everyone.
COVID-19 is a human tragedy, but it has also created a generational opportunity, an opportunity to build back a more equal and sustainable world. The response to the pandemic and to the widespread discontent that preceded it must be based on a new social contract and a new global deal that create equal opportunities for all and respect the rights and freedoms of all.
Meanwhile, President Cyril Ramaphosa urged closer cooperation to fight the pandemic.
Our acts of care and solidarity should also deepen our collaboration to address humankind's most pressing challenges. Better education, eliminating poverty and underdevelopment, food security, climate change and gender-based violence.
The Nelson Mandela Lecture happens during the time when the Mandela family is mourning the loss of Zinzi Mandela, who was buried a day before the lecture. Mzondile Mbeji, SABC News, Johannesburg.